What's going on, everybody? This is Sean of Raw Select Music. I am back with yet another recent record pickups video. Whole lot of gems to share with you today. A whole slew of 7-inches, as well as a couple of LPs, both new and old. And yeah, that's pretty much all I've got for an introduction. So with that being said, let's talk about these guys. Continuing my journey into European library music, I have this set of 3 7-inches from Black Cat Records from an Italian library group titled iMark IV. I didn't really know anything about these, but as I was digging around on Jet Set looking through their tagged library records, I stumbled across these, and one of them was on sale, and seeing as how I had 2 more of them in my want list, I figured I might as well pick them all up. And while I would love to play all 3 of these for you guys, I'm gonna go with the one that really stuck out to me, which is this track right here. This is Candy, and to me, this is like the most indicative of what I look for when it comes to library music. So I'm gonna play it for you now, and hopefully you can get a pretty quick idea as to why I'm going after library records. Research on this before I started shooting this video, but all of these records are fantastic. Run the gamut of low BPM to mid-tempo funk soul library, funk soul jazz library jams. All of these are great. They seem like they go for a relatively inexpensive amount of money, and highly recommend that you give these guys a listen. So next up, we have yet another record in the Street Corner Music Flips series. This one is with Kayla Maestro, Goddamn Chan, and Landscape, and this was the one that I was looking for. No disrespect to the Carlos Nino Flip 7-inch, but this was the one that I was hoping for, largely because I am a ginormous fan of Kayla Maestro, and basically anytime that he puts stuff out, I make sure that I jump on it immediately. This one's much more of a classic soul flip with a lot of the vocals still intact, and it's just done masterfully. While the other two tracks on here, the ones from Goddamn Chan and Landscape, are both good, it's really the Kayla Maestro that is the big selling point on this one. So let's get back at it. Listen. We've only just begun. Say about this other than it's 7-inch of 3 masterful flips of the same sample, and you're doing yourself a grave injustice if you haven't picked this up. Next up, there wasn't really much meaning behind picking this record up other than the track that's on here by the New Holidays, Maybe So, Maybe No, which most people probably know from the Mayor Hawthorne cover that appeared on his I can't remember the name of the album. I've always been a huge fan of that Mayor Hawthorne track, and then when I found the original, basically sounds exactly like the cover, I figured I might as well grab a copy of it. And there's another track on the flip of this record from Creative Source, You Can't Hide Your Love. It's all right. It's fairly unremarkable, in my opinion, but that New Holidays, Maybe So, Maybe No track is an absolute classic and definitely a worthy addition to any funk and soul record collector's collection. So let's give this guy a listen. Speaking of nice little additions to my funk and soul collection, we've got a track from the label Soul by the Pound, Jim Sharp. 2 remixes of classic funk and soul tracks that pretty much everybody should know, Funky Dope Man and I Choose You. Personally, I prefer to highlight the I Choose You remix, just because, once again, much like the Dusty Donut series, which I believe Jim Sharp is a part of that label, it's just absolutely bananas and needs to be heard to be believed. funny because just by putting some sample drums or a drum machine underneath these classic samples, how much it really just adds a little extra hit and a little extra bump to them. And it seems like Jim Sharp is very much aware of that idea and does it to great effect on both the Funky Dope Man remix and the I Choose You remix. So once again, another wonderful record to add to the collection where you still give off the vibe of classic funk and soul, but also giving it that little bit of extra hip hop bounce and really just making for a great tool for any DJ to have in their arsenal. And seeing as how I saw a second copy of it floating around on a different website, I might end up getting two of these guys because rocking doubles of these be a lot of fun. All right, last up in the 7-inch selection, we've got two tracks from L. Michaels Affair. We've got L. Michaels Affair featuring Bobby Arosa. I think that's how you say his name. This is Reasons, which is a non-album track, as well as the track Hips, which is on the Adult Themes LP that they put out this year. Seeing as how this guy right here is already on the album, I figure I might as well play this guy for you. So I can give you a better idea as to what it sounds like. Definitely a lot more understated, and I really like Bobby Oroza's super longing and emotional yet still somehow sweet vocal stylings on here. I really do need to pick up his This Love album from last year. But yeah, really glad that I picked this 7-inch up. I really like the Hips track. I really like the Reasons track. Pretty killer 7-inch, but at this point I expect nothing less from Big Crown Records, because consistently they've been putting out amazing funk and soul records for like the last 5 years or so. And speaking of which, I might as well talk about the L. Michaels Affair 2020 album, Adult Themes. This is a record that I've wanted since the beginning of the year. I think it was one of the first records when it was initially announced I got super excited for. Don't get it twisted, I love L. Michaels Affair's cover stuff that they've been doing with Wu-Tang and the nearly impossible to find Isaac Hayes Walk On By covers album. But I really do think L. Michaels Affair are at their most interesting when they're doing albums of original works, and good lord did they come through on this album. I've only listened to it a handful of times up until this point, but yeah, this is easily gunning for a slot in my top five. Just absolutely incredible dramatic arrangements, some of the best horn work that I've heard on a record in ages, and it still retains a lot of that grimy dark atmosphere that was present on those Wu-Tang cover albums, while at the same time carving out a really, really cool sound for themselves. And it really does seem like when they took on the task of trying to invoke the sound of a lot of European library music, they really did their homework, because this really does sound like some authentic library shit. And I think the track that I'm gonna play from this one is Life of Pablo, because seriously, that was, even upon my first listen of this record, was an immediate highlight to me. So let's dig into that. My full thoughts and opinions on this record at some point, but even right here and now I can highly recommend it. Really cool creative arrangements, really tight musicianship, awesome melodies, just an overall awesome listen, and easily one of my favorite records of the year. All right, now moving into a record that I don't know pretty much anything about. I picked it up because I've become increasingly a bigger fan of Mndsgn's Paxico Records label, and I saw that it was marked down, and seeing as how I'm always looking to expand my collection of instrumental hip-hop records, the little preview listen that I gave to this record, Vacation or Wavelengths, I thought, wow, I should probably give this one a listen and pick it up. And from the little bits and pieces of this record that I've listened to thus far, I'm really glad that I did. It seems like it's got a really nice mix of different moods, different styles, different approaches to instrumental hip-hop. So let's go with the sine wave. The sine wave is that one, right? That's the sine wave, right? Don't laugh at me. And let's listen to the opening track, Sentient, to give you an idea of what this guy sounds like. Excited to sit down and listen to this guy a lot more. I really like the vibe on it, the use of electronics, the use of some really hard-hitting drums. This is honestly more along the lines of the stuff that I've been into when it comes to instrumental hip-hop. But it sounds like this guy's gonna be right up my alley, and I'm really looking forward to giving it a full in-depth listen and letting you know my thoughts and opinions on it at a later date. So look forward to that review coming sometime soon, hopefully. All right, then last up, we have the record that actually inspired all of my recent record purchases, because this was a record that I have been dying to get on LP for the longest time. It's been sold out since its initial 2014 release. It's basically been impossible to buy outside of going on auctions or buying it through Discogs. But while digging around on Disc Union, I was curious after listening to Lo Siento, Max Graef's 2018 record, I just was like, oh, maybe, just maybe, I would find a copy of it. And I did. And that record is Max Graef's Rivers of the Red Planet. Oh my god, I forgot how good this record is. This is Max Graef at his early production best. So many good tracks on here. This brilliant mix of house and hip-hop, jazz, funk, like everything he does on this record sounds so good. And I'm quite honestly surprised that this isn't a record that's even more celebrated as one of the great electronic albums of the 2010s. So trying to pick one track to demo this record to you guys is nearly impossible, but I think I'm gonna go with Itzehoe, as I think it encapsulates Max Graef's early house sound absolutely perfectly and shows off why early on in his career he was such a celebrated producer, and rightfully so. Yeah, that groove, that thump, that bump is present on pretty much every track on here. And the hip-hop stuff works, the jazz stuff works, everything on this record works. I will do a full review of this record at some point, or maybe even just talk about my favorite Max Graef records and tracks. But yeah, I'm so happy to have finally added this to my collection. And if you can get your hands on it, MP3, CD, LP, doesn't matter, get this record. Highly recommend it. One of the best records of the 2010s. And a very welcome addition to my record collection. So that's gonna be it for me today, guys. Thanks as always for watching. If you've listened to any of these records yourself, please let me know what you think of them down in the comments. If you wanna hear any of these records for yourself, please head over to my WordPress blog, because that's where I post music links to any of the tracks that I talk about on this channel. Make sure you head over to my Mixcloud, where you can check out Raw Select Radio, the audio component of this YouTube channel, and make sure that you're around here at 8 p.m. Japan time for Live from the Record Room, my DJ live streams that I've been doing on a weekly basis. There you can hear me play records such as the ones that I talk about in these videos, as well as the ones that I don't get a chance to talk about on this channel. Links to everything, as always, down in the description. But that's gonna be it for me today, guys. Thanks as always for watching, and I will catch you in the next video. So until then, peace out!